You have someone who's inherently an energy vampire in your life. Some people consume tremendous amount of energy. That's what a vampire does, right? Bites you in the neck and suck the life out of you. There are three types of people. There are uplifting people, there are neutral people, and there are not uplifting people. Okay. Let's define what this is. An uplifting person, I spend 5 minutes with an uplifting person, I walk away, I feel great and go like, wow, that was an amazing conversation. A neutral person, I spend 5 minutes with them, I walk away, I'm still the same. A not uplifting person, I spend 5 minutes with them, I walk away and I go like, oh my God, that was exhausting. Right? And you've probably experienced that in your life. The next question is, are they a transient energy vampire or inherently an energy vampire? Right? What's a transient energy vampire? Just say John is going through a hard time in life because his dad is dying of cancer, for example. And for 3 years, he consumes a lot of energy. You know, he's always down, you need to uplift him, he's feeling very sad. It's okay. You give him that energy because he's your friend, and that's what we do. We express compassion, empathy, and love, and we support our friends during difficult times. What's someone who's inherently an energy vampire? Someone who's inherently an energy vampire has always been this way. For decades, they just haven't changed. They're just not an uplifting human being at all. My guru taught me the best way to do this is to practice the art of being affectionately detached. So the concept of being affectionately detached is to not engage with someone, right? Just to be kind, to be gentle, to be sincere and loving towards them, but not engaging with them. What's another way to protect yourself from an energy vampire? Is to place the burden of responsibility on them. If they fulfill their task and come back to you, then go out of your way to help them. To treat energy the same way you treat money. It's a finite resource that needs to be wisely managed, wisely reallocated, and wisely invested. If I took 10% of my energy and I gave it to John, that's 10% I could have given to my spouse, my business, the things and people that I love. Energy has no ability to discriminate between what's positive and what's negative. If I took a watering can and I watered a garden bed, would the weeds grow or the flowers grow? Both, right? Water has no ability to discriminate between the weeds and the flowers. Whatever I water starts to grow. Energy is the same way as well. If I took energy and I invested it into something negative, it will grow and become more negative. If I took energy, invested it into something positive, it will grow and become more positive. Whatever you invest energy into starts to grow and manifest in your life. To know yourself is one of the greatest gifts you can give yourself. Reallocate your energy between people who uplift you and people that don't uplift you. Life is meant to be lived joyously. Pursue a lifestyle that results in happiness. I never chase happiness. I pursue a lifestyle where the byproduct of the lifestyle is happiness. In order to find out what the lifestyle is, I need to know what my purpose in life is. In order to do that, I need to spend time with myself each day to find out who and what's important in my life, take that finite amount of energy that I have each day, focus it into those things, and also believe in your ability to manifest something in your life.